AI-driven data analytics in Power BI. Hi, I'm M. Asif Hussain from KnowHow Academy. What are we going to learn from this video? You are going to understand how AI is helpful for Power BI. We are going to see what are the different possible options that Power BI has given in order to work with artificial related intelligence visuals. We are also going to see what kind of inbuilt AI option can be analyzed depending upon the business performance through a report. When I talk about artificial intelligence, we all know that artificial intelligence is booming in today's world. Whenever we listen the word artificial intelligence, we get multiple things or multiple technologies in our mindset, such as we think about ChatGPT, we think about chatbot, and we think about machine learning, we think about deep learning, you know, we think about all these things. But there are various artificial intelligence related options in our Power BI. I would even like to show that we have something called as Microsoft Teams, which we all are aware of. We all know what is Microsoft Teams, right? If anyone of you are not working in any organization, if you are a fresher, then you might not be probably using Microsoft Teams. But Microsoft Teams is such an important thing in every individual's life who have started their career and who are doing their jobs and so on. Because Microsoft Teams is the option where you can discuss, chat, conduct meetings with your colleagues in an organization that you are working in. So through Microsoft Teams, you can link up your Power BI. You can share your report through Microsoft Teams chat to your colleagues in an organization. So if you see here, I am here in the Microsoft Teams. I have an application called Power BI. That application, you can get it from here. Okay. So when I have got this Power BI application, what all the dashboards, what all the different reports that I have created in this particular ID that I have logged in. Okay. So all those things you will get it here. And this is completely the web version as how we use Power BI service. It is also in the same way. As you can see, I have multiple reports here and all. So for example, if I click on this Power BI report, and if I would like to share this report to someone in my organization, to my team lead, to my colleague. So rather than sharing the Power BI file, I can share my Power BI report through Teams also. So I can chat in Teams and I can send to whomever I want. Okay. So this is one interesting thing that Power BI has given us by enabling Power BI with our Microsoft Teams. So if I talk about the different visuals that Power BI has given us with artificial intelligence related, that will be helpful for analyzing the business scenarios, is that if I walk you through the different visuals, we have this key influencers visual, we have question and answer visual, we have decomposition tree, we have narrative visual. So these are the four visuals that are related with purely artificial intelligence, and where it will give you the insights by just giving some keywords whichever you would like to search for. So that is one thing. And even some important visuals are also there which are related to data science technology also. For example, if you take through R scripting, okay, if you talk about the Python and paginated reports, so these are also linked up with AI and data science technology. If I talk to you about the analytics part of data transformation, whenever we talk about data transformation in Power BI, obviously we go with Power Query Editor, right? So Power Query Editor is inbuilt data transformation feature that Power BI has given us. And that's where this Microsoft Power BI is leading in the market. Now, if I show you the Power Query Editor, we have a separate section for it called Text Analytics. We have Vision, we have Azure Machine Learning. It will invoke us the Microsoft Azure ML models. Okay, there are various machine learning models which are interlinked up with Microsoft Azure. Those models we can invoke it here in our Power BI. If you want to understand the score sentiment, we can go with the text analytics that we have in AI. So if you are going for a data transformation and if you would like to use artificial intelligence in order to help be helpful for your data transformation part, yes, obviously we can go with these three options here. Even I would like to show you one more interesting thing is that, so if I walk you over one small example, I'm taking a visual here. I have one data set. Okay, let me show you a data set. I have one data set here, and in this data set we have different columns. For example, if you see here, we have order ID, order date, shipment date. Now what is this order date and shipment date? So I have a e-commerce platform data with me. Now order date is something where the customers have placed a order of a product. Now this particular order, when it got delivered to the customer, that is the shipment date. Okay, so I have the order date and I have the shipment date. So the time duration that is taking in between the order date to the shipment date, so this particular data has segregated it into different shipment modes, such as if it is getting delivered it on the same day, then we have the same day option. If it is getting delivered in 1 to 2 days, then it is a standard or first class. So there are different modes that they have segregated in it. We have customer names and we have segment, from which country, from which city, from which region did we get this order. And we have the numerical data, such as how much sales each customer have done. Okay, so how much sales each customer has done, how much profit each customer has done, what is the quantity, how much discount we have given on each product. So every information is there in this particular data set. Now if I would like to compare how much sales I have got in my 20 for example, if you consider here in our order date, it is starting from 2017 or 2016. So when I compare with 2017 to 2018, how much sales I have got, as we have the date related information, which is very clear. We have year, we have month, and we also have a date. So if I walk you over with a small example, let me take a column chart here. So in this column chart, let me drag the date information. Okay, then even let me drag the profit. So if I would like to see, if I would like to see how much profit I have got when compared to each particular year, okay, 2016 2017 2018 and 2019, let me on the data labels here. So if I on the data labels, and I would like to even show you in a very clear way, so let me make it a little bit bolder. Okay, so if we see here in this data labels, we can clearly consider that in the year 2016, 50k is my profit. Okay, and in my 2017, 62k is my profit, 2018, 82k is my profit, and in 2019, 93k is my profit. Let me increase the size of the years as well. So we can see that, here we have different options, right? So in the year 2016, I have got a profit of 50,000. In the year 2017, I have got a profit of 62,000. In the year 2018, I have got a profit of 82,000. In the year 2019, I have got a profit of 93,000. So now we also know that in our data that we have extracted, after year we have quarter, after quarter we have month, after month we have day. So if I just drill it down into one level, okay, I get different quarters. Okay, so now the very interesting point is that if you consider in the year 2016, where my business have started, and the data I have it starting from 2016. So let me consider 2017 for your easy understanding. So in the quarter two, I have a profit of 12,000. And in the quarter three, I have a profit of quarter three, I have a profit of 17,000. And in the quarter four, I have a profit of 23,000. So if you see here, again, the quarter one, when it started in the next academic year, in the next year, which is 2018, in the quarter one, I have got 11K sales and 11,000 sales. From 23,000 in my previous year to 11,000, it got a very drastic footfall. Am I right? There's a drastic footfall here. So now, how will you, being a developer or a data analyst, how are you going to explain this scenario to your client? How are you going to explain this scenario to your customer, to your team leader? What is the reason that you are going to give it to you? It is very difficult being a individual we need to go back, study, understand the numerical concept in it. We need to go through each and every row. We need to understand the which product is getting, you know, more demand or which product is getting less demand. Okay, from which region we are getting more sales or more profit, or so on. When this kind of information, it is becoming very difficult for a person to answer or to give a probable solution to the client or customer, AI has made it so easy for us that artificial intelligence itself is giving you the explanation why there is a footfall or why there is a downfall that has come when compared to previous quarter to the next quarter. Rather than you identifying, taking some couple of days or couple of months time to know this, the whole concept behind this one, then give a probable solution, you can do it in one single two steps using AI. So how can you do that? If you see here, if I click on this particular quarter where I got a very less profit, I'll right click it and I have something called as analyze. It is giving you the explanation why there is a decrease. If you see here the analysis is telling that within few seconds I have got this result. So it is giving us that 50.91% there is a decrease in some of the profit between the quarter 4 of 2017 to the quarter 1 of 2018. All right. So with how much percentage? 50.91%. Why there is a decrease of 50.91%? There are various reasons that they have given it. If you see here, sum of profit by year, quarter and region, if you consider, there is a very good intake of profit in the year quarter 4 of south, from the south region. But if you see here, we are getting the huge loss from the central region. If I talk about a region perspective, again, if you see here, if you take by year, quarter and region, we are getting very less thing from the central one. Okay, so if I again talk you with the subcategory part by comparing it with the year and quarter, we are getting a good amount of profit from machines and binders. But if you see here, there are very less profit that we are getting from these subcategories, from phones, copiers and accessories. Okay, so like this, Power BI itself is giving you the insights. There are different suggestions that they have given. They compared it, okay? One they have compared it with week number, one they have compared it with a subcategory, one they have compared it with the region, okay? Another time they have compared it with the day, again they have compared it with the day name, with the state, from which state we are getting less profit. So when we can get this kind of information in just one to two clicks, in the fraction of seconds, don't you think that this interesting future can make you understand, or the client understand, the business in a very easy way? So if you want to find out this same 50.91% decrease in the sum of profit between 2017 quarter 4 to 2018 quarter 1, I think you need to use some XYZ DAX functions. You have to do the transformation and do all the different calculations and get the result out of it. Am I right? So the complete time it is getting avoided. So we are getting the probable solution. If you want to showcase this one to your visual, then what you can do is that you can just click on this add button and you will get this particular visual here. Okay, you can get this particular visual here. So you can show this kind of visual in the report as well. Okay. You can show this kind of visual in the report as well. This will be helpful for you. So if you see here, if I show this kind of information by telling that, okay, as you can see that there is a downfall from the New York state where I'm getting very huge profit, which is getting down, right? So my dear viewers, what I'm going to tell is that the feature that I have explained it to you just now, it can create a huge impact in your decisions and in your report. Because the same reason, if you would like to find out manually or using any DAX function or using any inbuilt feature of Power BI other than this feature which I have explained it to you, it will take a lot of days, it will take a lot of time. Okay, so but this feature is giving it to you in a very easy go, 1, 2, 3 clicks, done. Okay, so now you don't have one solution to answer to this kind of question asked by the client, why there is a difference. You have multiple options that Power BI is giving it to you using AI, right? Using the subcategory, using the region, using the day name, and using the different information that we have in a data set. So you have multiple options to explain it to your client why there is a footfall from 2017 quarter 4 to 2018 quarter 1. Okay, so these are the different AI enabled features that Power BI has given it to us. Even there is an option called a Copilot that has come up into Power BI, which requires the license, premium license for this one. So that also have AI built, chat GPT built features, which will be much more helpful for you in your report or dashboards. So these are the different AI driven analytics options that we have it in Power BI. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.